Hi, it's Naomi. I am doing a little experiment here. I'm not going on camera, and we're going to jump right into the subject of this training. So let me know in the comments after watching the training if you prefer this format or you prefer seeing me a little on screen. Okay, if you want to show a map of your city, or you're doing a travel blog, or you're a teacher reading excerpts from books, one cool way of grabbing your viewers' attention is using a magnifying effect. Let's start with this map. I have a map here of Washington, D.C. The objective here is to tell your viewers a little bit about the historical buildings in D.C., keeping their attention on the building along with the location on the map. I'm going to duplicate it by highlighting it and pressing Ctrl plus D. I'll hide the copy for a moment because I want to turn the map on track 1 to a black and white. We'll go to Visual Effects and add the color adjustment effect to the first layer. Change the brightness and contrast to 0 and saturation to -100. Now, I'm not sure why TechSmith doesn't default everything to 0. Anyway, let's turn track 2 back on and change the opacity to 50. We're now going to enlarge this top track and align it somewhat to the bottom track. We don't want to enlarge it so much that we make it difficult to have things line up close to each other, but enlarged enough that we will have a magnified effect. As you can see, you will not be able to align exactly in all spots since it is larger. You need to decide what are the specific places on the map you will want to point out and align close enough to those. And let's put the opacity back to 100%. Go to Annotations, Style, and Bold, and select the circle. Right-click and select Add to Timeline at Playhead. Extend the circle to the full length of the map on track 3. Now let's put the opacity of the circle to 50%. We'll go to Visual Effects and add the Media Matte effect to the circle. Actually, let's put that opacity up to 75% so we can see the circle better. What we want to do now is to move the circle over each of the buildings and make sure it is large enough to show the full building and sort of give a magnified look. We see here with the Lincoln Memorial, the circle should actually be a little larger to hide track 1's Lincoln Memorial building. Let's enlarge the circle. Let's check the other buildings. Okay, we can now put the opacity back to 100% and double-check the buildings one more time within the circle. It looks different enough to appear magnified. Now we want to sell this magnified look to the viewer. First, we have to duplicate the shape by pressing Ctrl plus D and remove the media mat on the copy. Now let's add 3 points to this shape's width and height to make it slightly larger than the shape on track 3. We'll go up to the Annotations tab and bring the opacity of the fill down to 0. For the outline, you can change to your branding colors or whatever color you want. I'm going to change it to my dark blue. I'll also change the thickness to 15. Now we'll go to the Drop Shadow visual effect and add it to the border shape on track 4. I'm going to adjust this drop shadow to sell the magnified glass distance from the map. I'll put the shadow at bottom center and change the color to a full black. I'll put the offset at 15, the opacity to 65%, and the blur will stay at 10. Now, I want to put a tint on the colored map on track 2, as there are sections of the map that are pure white. I want to sell the illusion of glass. To make sure I get the tint I want, I'll select both shapes on track 3 and 4 and move the circles over the Smithsonian National Museum of Art. I'll scroll down so I can see track 2 and put the color tint visual effect on track 2. So there is no confusion, I'll name track 1 as black and white since the thumbnails for both tracks are showing as color. I'm going to change the light tone of the color tint to a cyan and the dark tone to a blue. And I don't want it so deep a tint, so let's put the intensity to 25. Okay, we're almost all set. Let's add a little animation to this and some information about each building. We'll start by highlighting both Track 3 and Track 4 and moving them to the White House building. Let's first label these tracks so we don't get confused. Colored Map, Media Mat, and Border Magnify. What we are going to do is set up an information group which we can copy and paste the group for other buildings. We'll do this first and add the animation last. Go to Annotations, Shapes, Bold, and drag the gray rectangle to the canvas. I'm going to change this to the same color as my magnifying glass. I'll also round the corners with the visual effect and place corner rounding onto the rectangle. I'll change the rounding corners to 40 and adjust the width and height, keeping in mind this will be the size for all the building information panels. I want to keep a good portion of the map still showing, but large enough to contain information. Let me also extend this on the track a little. Now I will duplicate this and make the duplicate white. I'll change the rounding so the top is not rounded. I'll adjust the height and width so the bottom will ultimately become a border, with both the inside and outside having rounded corners. I'll go to the media bin and add an image I have of the White House and adjust the height and width for inside the information panel above the white shape. Let me make this the same length on the track and add rounding to the picture. I'll remove the rounding from the bottom and we see with the image that a 40 radius doesn't work. So we'll use the slider to round the corners further on the image. Let's zoom in on the canvas a little by pressing Ctrl and the plus sign. We'll make a few adjustments to the sides of the image so the border is more even. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now let's add a text block over the white section. I already have a text box set in my favorites, so I will use that. Change the color to black. We'll also uncheck auto resize text because we want the text to always be the same size and fit within these margins. Let's change the alignment to left and top and adjust the box so we have some white space for the margins. Let me adjust the length of this on the track. For this font, I'm going to change the size to 25. Let's add some information for the White House and make sure it all fits. Looks pretty good. I'm going to adjust the top and bottom margins slightly. A couple more things before we group this together. Let's add another rectangle here, adjust the height, and make it the same dark blue color. Whoops, let's move that down below the main information block background and adjust the length. We'll go back to the Border Magnify track and copy selected effects for the drop shadow and paste it to the information block bottom background shape. Now let's group all of the information panel together, including the horizontal line, and rename the group Information Panel. Let's also go into the group and rename the tracks to keep things straight. Bar, bottom panel, background text, image, and text. I'll move the text track so it is above the background text track. Okay. Let's close out of this. I'm going to put a slide right transition on the front and back of this group. On the back transition, I will right click and select reverse transition. Okay, our last step is adding animations to all of this. So let's place our playhead at the end of the information panel group. Click on the media mat track and press Shift plus A to add a custom animation. Let's move it so the beginning of the animation starts at the end of the information panel. Move the playhead to after the end of the animation and move the media mat circle to the Lincoln Memorial. Now put your playhead on the end of the animation. Making sure the animation is highlighted yellow, press Ctrl plus C to copy it. Click on the Border Magnify track and press Ctrl plus V to paste the animation. Now click on the information group and press Ctrl plus C to copy it and Ctrl plus V to paste, which will place the duplicate group at the start of the playhead. Now move the playhead forward to see the information panel. Move the information panel to the Lincoln Memorial so it is attached to the Magnify border. Let's rename this group Lincoln Memorial Information. I'll open the group and slide my Lincoln Memorial image over the White House image on the image track. I'll wait for the green outline to appear and select Replace with Clip Speed. I'll click on the text track and replace the text with information about the Lincoln Memorial. I can now close out of this group. For each of the other buildings, I would follow the same steps. Let's do one more sped up for you and take a look at what it all looks like. Now you can use your imagination and use the same principle for magnifying Media Book's poem as you read the stanzas.
Then said Almitra, "Speak to us of love." And he raised his head and looked upon the people, and there fell a stillness upon them. And with a great voice he said,
if you are in a webinar discussion group, you can stop and start at each stanza's location or sentence or paragraph, giving time to discuss what is magnified in the text and displaying on the right or left imagery, equations, video, whatever would be appropriate to amplify the text that is magnified. So let me know how you think you will use this magnification effect in your videos. Also, let me know if you like this format of my not being on camera and just jumping right into the training. And if you like this video, you may like one of these other videos. So don't forget to subscribe, and until we meet again, have a wonderful day.